You're going up, needle, block. So this is your exit out of your, you know, 2 foot back hamstring into your discount. You guys can all do it. Needle, block. 2 feet rounded. Needle, block. About 10 on each leg, always doing both legs. Again, when you lift your leg up to needle, I want you to find a square with your hip, and then block. And step down. Yes, block, step down. Block, step down. Round your back, and bend your knees.
Goal, and
tall and set. Place your hand down, turn, and turn your hip. Look under your armpit where her head is. So we want her head looking under her armpit, square her hip, step down, one, two, up, two, walk. Tall and set. Again, the goal of that is the plant hands for her to be tall and tight and for this to be aligned so that she's not bending this way, she's not leaning, she's not moving forward, which is what often happens in a roundup. So her to feel, 5 minutes, thank you. So for her to feel where her strongest point is, which is the power on that one shoulder and hand, and then look under the armpit. Looking in, head in, looking under the armpit, stepping up to lock. This is the mechanics of a roundup. Lift your hands, palm tight, head in, turn, look under your armpit. Yes, squaring out the hips, step down, one, two, hips under, up to lock. Love, love, love that.
If your second hand comes down and you're not square to the step down, you will go crooked. There's no other way to explain it. So unless you're doing a side cartwheel, landing sideways or a ground dog going this way, by the time your second hand comes down, the snap has to have happened already. There's not enough time to correct it. So that mid, like I demonstrated with that quarter drill, is super important in understanding that, ab activation to quarter turn yourself to step in.
Do you see how like all of these basics are every basis when you get to higher level gymnastics? And for building confidence. The actor that does this is not going to go straight down the ground. Okay, next drill. Panel mat, just simply doing a cartwheel. Draw a line across the middle of the panel mat. So, reach, step down. What I like to see is a rebound. She's going to do a rebound. The cartwheel, step down, rebound. So, she gets used to closing that second leg, and that is just simply for the reach. Then, taking her over to the low beam. Cartwheel, rebound off the low beam. Again, what we're looking for here is the head snap. And she didn't fully square, but you can see she stood up out of the rebound with one arm first. So her head didn't snap, and her second hand didn't turn, and her shoulders didn't square up.
You know, on vault dismounts, you get that. On vault dismounts. On vault landing, if they're not square, you can't play a game with a line, because if they're not square when they go in the air, they're not going to land square. So it tells them that they didn't snap soon enough. Because the rebound backwards has to be in line with the beam.
And then moving through to the beam. And I like to do the progression in this order of those confidence. Round up onto the panel mat again with a line so that they snap down, chest comes up. Then moving on to the beam. We're doing another one. Okay. Onto the beam. Hands on the beam, feet on the mat behind, so they're not worried about their feet, but a line on the mat so their feet still land in position. And we're just looking here for the arm placement, the second hand, their hips to square out, their head, and a good strong snap down. And usually, once you move them, just put them back a bit to do it on the beam. So she had never done roundups before, which is what I loved about this, is that she moved, and we only spent like, she did maybe 3 of each of these progressions. And then we did roundup side tucks. So what I like is that when she did get her feet on the beam through the roundup, she didn't hold back. Which often, once you put them on the beam to land on the beam, the roundup starts to shrink and everything shrinks up. And the value of taking the progressions in that order is that it's like, oh, it's the same thing. In her head, it's the same thing, so she simply does it the same way. And then round up back tuck off low beam on snap and on side. Second dance position. It's important, you can see it right there. It is turning. So you want that second hand. Turning. Do you have something to add about the second hand position?
No, but it's just if you're in side cartwheel position, your shoulder is
right.
Square, right?
Right.
The second hand position, if you're running up past the square shoulder, it's going to turn down.
Which is why we did that, take that slow motion round off so that it feels good.